Hello friends, good morning and good evening everyone. ALP here. So today I'm going to discuss what is my future plan for this coming days, what I'm going to do, what things we are going to discuss on this channel. So this is very surprising to you all. Mainly the machines, DC machines and AC machines, and their design aspects and design, whatever the we studied in academics, because mostly this is a subject in M.Tech for postgraduate students. So this subject is very useful. The things, everything in a detailed manner we are going to study. We are going to take one of the example. So for example, in the next immediate video, I am going to plan 110 volt DC motor design. So how we will design the DC motor from scratch, everything from basics to the everything I am going to discuss. It may take some time, the video may be lengthy. I will try to post in parts, part 1, part 2, like that if possible. Otherwise maybe half an hour length. So each and everything in a detailed step by step manner I am going to explain it. So for example, how to choose the stator dimension, how to choose the diameter, and how to choose the commutators, and how to choose armature winding, how to choose field winding, how to size them, what insulation we have to consider, and what is the air gap length. So what is the efficiency, how we will calculate efficiency. So there will be some assumptions on many parameters. So what parameters I am assuming initially? So we will assume some parameters, we will start doing design. At the end, what happens? The parameters may be modified due to some round off or some assumptions. So how those parameters getting modified also we are going to calculate. What is the allowable error for those parameters? How much, say for example, if it is within 10%, then okay. So like that. So all the performance parameters we are going to calculate at the end, like I square R losses, the losses in the armature, the losses in the poles, the losses in the yoke, and the frictional and windage losses. And so lot of parameters we are going to calculate manually, everything by hand, so that you can get better feeling of doing design. So initially, as I told, a small motor I am choosing, most of the parameters I am giving some clear cut guideline. So if this is the rating, then what we have to take, this is the rating, then what we have to take, like that I am explaining. I am going to explain all the parameters. So once the basic design of one of the DC motor is clear, I mean we finished it, then I am going to plan a detailed discussion on each and every parameter, like a subjective discussion, so that the audience, whoever are watching these videos, they already know how to design one motor, because I am explaining in the session. After that, I am going to explain the importance of each and every parameter in small videos, so that you people can get better understanding. So how we are how the parameter is impact. So before, directly if I say theory or subject like that, then you may not feel that much important. So after discussing the design, you know the importance of each parameter. So whoever interested to watch this video on this motor design, whoever wants to know, so please comment in the comment section, yes, like that, so that I can better feel it, and I know the requirements, I know whoever interested in it, and he hit the like button also, so that it gives me a good strength and good boost up for my next videos. If you like this, if you enjoy the content on this video, then please share this video to your friends and all, and don't forget to subscribe to this channel, so that whenever I'm uploading videos, you will get notifications. Yeah, this is about I have for today, guys. So I hope this video content is informative. We will meet in next video. Bye.